the times now.
Uganda decides.
Even from a distance, the Guruguru Hills can be seen rising majestically over Clark County. They are too imposing not to be noticed. Their historical and cultural importance cannot be overemphasized. A 104 years ago, a fierce war to resist British colonial rule was fought here. It ended with the surrender of the Acholi in what came to be known as the Lamogi Rebellion. This is Lamogi sub-county, home to the Lamogi clan, one of the most influential clans in Amuru. The people here are fighters, warriors. To win them over, you must play a staff. Climbing the Guruguru Hills is back-breaking work, and it was a lot of work too for the colonial troops as they faced off with the Lamogi warriors.
The cause of the rebellion, after the British actually asked the Lamogi people to do the work, let's say that the number of the guns they had going to do this labor works, to arrest one of the Lamogi men who killed the two policemen for the British. The chief refused. Then they asked themselves, what are the whites are aiming at them now? After refusing, that is when the people actually started coming harsh to the British, started killing the white also. Then later, the white also revenge. They look for them where they were hiding. Then they kill one of the captain called Captain Tenner.
Guruguru was chosen as the base because of its strategic nature. The rocks and the high elevation make it a natural fortress.
So I'm off to see the water guard. It is a strategic hiding place, and we're told the fighters and their commanders used to hide here during the rebellion to wait for the advancing British troops down the valley, the Guruguru Valley.
They used to put the quarter guards here, okay, while waiting for the British army to come. After seeing them, then some of their guards here. This is where the captain was shot at the quarter guard.
The British captain?
Yeah, was shot from the quarter guard. He's the quarter guard.
So this used to be the last line of defense for the Lamogi troops.
The tall razor-sharp grass was a challenge to the colonial troops. The unfamiliar terrain caused them a number of casualties.
So during the rebellion, as the civilian population fled the villages, you know, running away from the advancing British troops, they, along with their families, came to hide here. At one point, we're told the British army came to the villages and found no population there. And it took them some time to establish that the civilians, that the villagers, were actually hiding here.
The caves also served as bunkers for the warriors who faced the superior firepower of the colonial military.
Oh, the bats!
Civilians used to bring foodstuffs as a way to show appreciation for the sacrifices made by the fighters.
Because the Mogi people were moving, following the hills, like Kilak, and then Guruguru, and then Keyo, via rivers.
The 1911 rebellion was fought largely because of the land. The chief feared that his people's land was about to be grabbed by the British. Coincidentally, AMURU leads in land wrangles to date. In AMURU, Lamogi will be the swing sub-county.
We don't want this division of the clans, these land wrangles, because it divides us too much.
It may be over 100 years since the defeat of the Lamogi, but the people here don't regret picking up arms. This land is beautiful and was worth every drop of blood. There are plans to turn Guruguru Hills into a tourist attraction. When the president visited in March, he directed the tourism ministry to begin work to gazette the place. And as election year approaches, the Lamogi manifesto is out. They want leaders and not politicians. Now they wait to make or break the vote. Ronald Kato, reporting for TNR.
The time's now. Uganda decides.